In this video, I will explain some of the new features that have been added in the latest firmware update. The most important change can be found in the new menu, the trace menu. Some of the trace functions did already exist, but they were within the display menu, but there's now a separate trace menu. In the trace menu, you can select which trace to operate upon, trace 1, 2 or 3, and then you can set certain features of the trace. You can freeze the trace, you can enable or disable it, but as you have always have to have at least one trace enabled, you cannot disable the last trace. You can set one of the calculation options. There's one new option there, which I'll explain a bit later. And you can normalize, or you can subtract. And in subtracting, you can choose which trace to subtract from this trace. And you can copy the trace. I will demonstrate what happens when you do the copy of the trace. So we copy the trace 1, which we currently have to trace 2. Then of course you don't see a lot, you see here some green, but if I change the frequency, you see the previous frequency measurement is stored in trace 2, the green trace, and trace 1 is still the live trace. As there are now two traces active, trace 2, which is enabled and which is frozen, I can go back to trace 1. I can disable the trace so that we only have that trace. I can go to trace 2 and stop the freezing. And now trace 2 has become the live trace. I freeze it again and go back to trace 1, enable it, and change the frequency of the trace 1. I can also store it to trace 3. Change the frequency again. And this is of course very handy if you have measurements and where you want to compare the results of one measurement with another measurement. So you have two traces that you can use for storage. Within the trace menu, we have the calculation options. And within the calculation options, we have a new option, table to trace. To demonstrate it, I will activate trace 2, frozen. And I'm going to enable the entry of a table. So we say it starts at 10 MHz at level minus 10. And so that's the first entry in the table. And we use now the second entry, we say 300 MHz, the level. Set the level to plus 10. And with that, you can use traces to draw lines on the screen. And for instance, those lines could be that a certain signal has to be below a line during the measurement, and you want to have a visual indication where that point is, where the trace should stay below. So with this, you can easily set a line or even multiple lines, because and now you can have a zone, which is the approval zone, and whenever you measure, it has to be within that zone. Another option for the table is that you use it as a compensation table to compensate for a frequency-dependent gain, for instance, of an amplifier during your measurements. For instance, you have an amplifier. Let's go for 2. Trace 2. Let's say you have an amplifier that has a gain of 20 dB at 10 kHz and a gain of 10 dB at 300 MHz. and there the gain is only 10 dB. Now, what you can do is you can subtract this line from the trace 1. So you go back to trace 1 and you do subtract, and we subtract trace 2. And what you see is we've now compensated for the frequency dependent gain of the amplifier. And you could do, of course, the same for a measurement antenna which has a certain sensitivity profile. And you can set that in the table, use the table to model the sensitivity, and then use it to compensate the measurement. In this release also, the marker menu has seen a small change. We go to the marker menu and we go to modify markers. Then the previous version you had to select which marker to operate on, but here the marker that you operate on is shown here at the top, marker 1, and everything you do is then relative to marker 1. But for instance, if I want to activate marker 2, I activate marker 2, I say it's a delta to marker 1, and now I can put marker 2 somewhere. But I can also put marker 2 on another trace. For instance, I put it on the trace 2. You see the color has changed of the marker. And as it's now on trace 2, I can put it here on top of that one. And as it's a delta marker, it measures now the frequency delta between the peak on trace 2 and the peak on trace 1. And this way the marker menu and the trace menu behave in a consistent way. There's also another new feature in the marker menu. As you can see here, we have a tracking marker that positions itself to the maximum of the scan. And then of course what you could do is do by averaging, find the average level and then position your marker so that you position it on a good place. But you can also do now trace average and watch how this number here changes. And by trace average, the marker still positions on the maximum, but the value that is being displayed is the average over the total trace. And that prevents that you have to seek with the position of the marker to a place where an average trace seems to be approximately in the middle. Because here the averaging over all measurements is done.